Hi, my name is Ashley White, and I'm a master stylist at Nicholas J. Salon in South Bend, Indiana. And today I'm going to show you how to do an open-ended curl on short hair. The few products that I'm going to be using today are Aveda's Air Control Hairspray for light prepping hairspray, some Control Paste to define the curls, and Control Force hairspray. I'm also going to be using a teasing brush, four clips, and a flat iron. What I'm first going to do is section her hair off into a few sections. Now she has short hair, so it might take a few clips just to grab it up. This is a great idea if you're ever styling your hair and want a more perfected look without getting overwhelmed. It's always a great idea to use some clips. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the back side. And since the back is really short, I'm only going to round under the back side. So I'm just going to take it and round it under just like that. And typically I would use a comb on somebody else to pull the hair out. But since I'm wanting you to do this at home and to do it on yourself, I'm using my fingers like I would suggest when I do my own hair. Now since we're getting to the side, I'm going to take a piece of section, probably about an inch wide. I'm going to put the flat iron in and I'm going to rotate the flat iron around. And notice how I'm doing it in a continuous motion. This way you don't get a weird kink in the hair or a line or anything funny like that. And I'm going to do it away from her face. And notice how I kind of make it straight at the end. See how you get this open-ended fun curl where it doesn't make it look like you did it with the flat or like with a curling iron or it's too perfected. And any of those back pieces, I'm just kind of rounding under just to kind of keep the continuous shape of her hair. Now for something a little bit more trendy, I'm just going to round under the other side because we're going to actually tuck this side and make it more smooth. So just kind of giving that nice round shape. Now because we want these curls to last all day long, I'm going to use a little bit of Air Control Hairspray. And I'm going to spray it onto her hair, especially on the side that we're going to be doing more of the waves on. This will help it lock in all day long, and it's really nice and movable because you can keep moving your hands through it, you can keep playing with it, and it gives you a nice hold, but it's not super strong. We're going to lock that in later. And just remember, just keep turning your hand around in a continuous motion. That makes it so you don't get the weird kinks. It's not like a curling iron in that way because you're still moving the flat iron around. Now, I am left-handed. If you're right-handed or left-handed, it really doesn't matter which way you turn the flat iron as long as you keep rotating it in the same movement. And some of these I'm just going to leave curled until the very end, and then we'll kind of pull them out and give them some nice definition. So I'm just going to spray a little bit more hairspray on there. And now once you start getting to the top and the back, you can kind of give it a little bit more bend than you did in the shorter parts because there's a little bit more hair to get that bend through. See how you get that nice curl? And then I'm just going to go back over to the other side. We're just going to give her a nice shape on the other side because we're going to eventually tuck this side. And then we're going to pull down the last section. I'm just going to give it a little bit more spray. And another trick is if you over-direct the hair just a little bit, and what I mean by over-directing is lifting up that hair so we want the most volume. So I'm gonna lean it over, slightly over her part, and I'm gonna curl backwards. This is gonna give it a lot more body towards the scalp. See how it gives you a little bit more lift up at the scalp? Now I'm just going to give her a light spray just to kind of pull that in place. I'm going to take my nice teasing brush. This is great. It's just a three bristle brush that will be really nice just to lift up some sections. And I'm just going to back comb. The nice part about this brush is you don't have to apply a lot of pressure. You can just lift up the hair and slightly brush back. It makes it really nice for any kind of formal updo or just a daily style, just to get that extra lift in your hair without holding your hair so hard and like going back and back and back and back. So I'm going to lift up some of these pieces, just give her a little extra lift. And on this side, I'm just going to slightly just take the brush on a slight angle, and I'm just going to brush down. And see how in these sections you really can't tell that it was actually teased at all, except for the volume that you're left with. Now I'm going to take a little bit of control paste. My rule of thumb is always to start with just a small amount, like a pea-sized amount, rub it really well into your hand, and I always start with the back. The reason I start with the back is that if you get too much product in your hands, at least it's in the back and it's not in the front where you notice it the most. So you always start with the back, and I'm just going to push my hands in, up, and out. So just remember, in, up, and out, because we want that nice fullness, that nice volume in there. And then I'm going to take this side, and I'm going to slightly tuck it. Then I'm going to go around to this side, and I'm just going to take my hands and redefine the curls. So see how it's nice and open-ended? You don't get that full round look. And that's because we used a flat iron. This is the difference between a flat iron and a curling iron. You're getting a different look, more of a trendy curl that's going to last all day. And you can still push your fingers in there. You can pull some of it out. But I really like the way it's swaying on Julie's face today and how it's just kind of swooping over and swooping out. Now I'm going to go back through with my Control Force hairspray, and I'm going to lock it in. Just give her a really nice spray. This will help hold it all day long. She won't have to worry about it moving anywhere. The nice part about this hairspray is it doesn't give you that really like crunchy feel though. And this is how to do a open-ended curl with flat iron.